Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market preparation video for January 23rd, 2019. So, my goodness, yesterday we saw some sellers coming in, and I know that might have been painful for a lot of folks. Let's take a look at this market here without any indicators on it first. And just realize that with the diamonds pushing up here, it really wasn't that big of a surprise to see us run into this downtrend resistance and need or require just a little bit of pullback or rest. The good news is this, that we built a nice level of support here with this price action right here. Nice level of support. So any rest or pullback in here, as long as it holds onto that support, we're in pretty good shape. A nice long consolidation would be what I would prefer. If we could consolidate like we did here for several days, just kind of rest in here, give us a nice little consolidation, relax a little bit, take a breath, let the market catch up here for a little while, that would be a real nice thing to see. So let's keep an eye on this, and hopefully it will hold up better. Now, even though there was some selling yesterday, I wrote in my blog this morning. And by the way, if anyone is interested in reading the blog, on every video, if you look in the description, very close to the top of the description, there is a link that will take you right back to the website blog. So please make sure and take advantage of that if you're interested in collecting a little bit more information about my daily preparation. Let's take a quick look here at what the market looks like after touching that 50-day moving average. So we pulled back to that 50-day moving average. One of the things I want everyone to kind of focus in on here is let's see if I can get rid of some of those lines. There we go. If I remove some of my drawings on here, you can see that we have our moving averages starting to move up here, trying to support that 50-day moving average or show support at that 50-day moving average. That will be critical if we can hold above that level. But the good news is, the silver lining is, we did see a defense by the end of the day. We bounced off of that 50-day moving average, and now we're seeing some follow through this morning. We're seeing some bullish buying going on following through this morning. Now, most of this bullish buying is really going to be based on earnings results. And the reason I say that is because there's really no tailwinds from markets around the world. Last night, Asian markets closed pretty close to flat, a little bit mixed, but pretty close to flat. Very little energy in Asian markets last night. And currently European markets are mostly lower and mixed. So not a whole lot of tailwind. So this is really being based on what's going on with earnings reports. So a lot of weight is going to be placed on those earnings reports today, particularly because there's really nothing on the economic calendar to move us around either. So let's take a quick peek here at the SPY, SPY. Very similar situation, but in a better price pattern. First, moving up through this downtrend, at least how I have it drawn. And you could have drawn it in a different way, that's okay. But as I have it drawn, moved up there nicely. Also, pulling back to this uptrend and bouncing right off of that uptrend. Now, I really wouldn't be surprised to see this pull back a little bit further, testing this area of support here, that little consolidation support through this area. But so far, looking really, really good. And once again, if we look at our moving averages, bouncing off of that 50-day moving average, and notice we have our 34 exponential, our 8 exponential, all coming up to try and provide some price support in this area. A little bit of a moving average squeeze trying to provide some support. Doesn't mean it will hold, but for now, that is the silver lining, that we had that bullish response coming in. And of course, this morning, gapping up slightly, trying to move higher. Let's take a look at the Qs. Qs also kind of a rough day. And as a matter of fact, if you just look at this without looking at anything else, this is an evening star pattern. That is a bearish candlestick pattern that would suggest more lows possible in the NASDAQ. Not what we want to see for sure, but let's also take a good look at what's happened here. First, NASDAQ has broken through its downtrend. Gotta like that. That looks really good to me. I like the fact that we're holding above this very important support level, and we built a little bit of price consolidation right here to help possibly provide us some support in this area to maybe bounce up off of there. Once again, if we take a look at that 50-day moving average, you can see we really did a hard test breaking down through that 50-day moving average, but buyers did do their job. The bulls defended that support level, pushing us back above. And also, just I'm going to repeat this over and over, I guess, but look at all the moving averages kind of lining up in here, trying to provide that little bit of support to price action. So it's really going to come down to these earnings reports, how they come out, how the market will fare here, and whether or not we can continue to support current prices. Let's take a look at IWM. IWM really in the same boat, crossed up here through this resistance, now pulling back. Once again, we have kind of an evening star pattern here, kind of a bearish pattern overall, but we're continuing to hold above support levels in here in the chart, and that is important. Price support levels are a key element to market direction. So if we can hold above that area, we're going to be in pretty good shape. And also keep in mind, IWM broke above its downtrend. Let's take a quick look at the moving averages here. And as you can see, holding above, we did a test of those areas and bounced off of that by the end of the day. So there is that little silver lining showing up here in the market. Can that fail? Yes, it certainly can fail. And once again, it's really going to come down to, it looks like we're going to open right in this area, going to come down to how well companies report and whether or not they can prove that these prices are sustainable. Let's take a look at the VIX. The VIX popping up yesterday, showing us some fear, and really right off of where we would kind of expect some of that to occur. If we pull this back, you can see I've got a price level support right through here, and we pulled back sharply, and then we catch that bounce up here. A little bit of fear maybe creeping into the market, and there's reason for that fear. Remember, we have tremendous amount of political uncertainty out there with the government shutdown, China negotiations, all those things, lots of political uncertainty out there in the market. We have the new concerns issued by the IMF, not the IMF, the international, it's IMF, by the IMF warning of a global shutdown. And then we have the issues, or not a global shutdown, but a global slowdown going on, kind of globally, a concern on growth starting to creep in to the market. So that's fueling some of the fear as well. So when we start adding up all of these things that are going on, China negotiations and all these kind of things going on, a little bit of fear maybe creeping into the market. Now, what adds to the potential volatility is earnings. Earnings always tend to add a little bit of element of volatility. So you kind of couple those things together, and we do have a recipe for added volatility. Now, what we don't want to see in here is we don't want to see that volatility creep back up above here. We want that price level of resistance to hold volatility in its place. I would suspect with the morning gap up, which continues to grow this morning. Right now, the Dow futures are suggesting a 170-point gap up this morning. So I would suspect that we will see that fear decline in just a little bit, but we'll have to watch that closely. If earnings results tend to start sliding the other direction, that could easily change. So keep an eye on that. Let's take a look at T21-22, that four-week new high, new low ratio. As you can see, yesterday we did get a bit of a rest, bit of a pullback here in T21-22. Now with our gap up this morning, I suspect we will be popping right back up into this area. So watch that close. And remember, it's okay. We can stay overbought for a period of time, just like we were oversold for a period of time down in here. But we're still reaching those areas where we have to be a little bit cautious. And I would just be cautious about overextending yourself or over trading long at this point. Have maybe a mix in your trades. Pick up some neutral to bearish type trades if you trade options, along with your long positions, just to kind of hedge yourself in the market, or use options to hedge your long positions, by the way. Because more pullback is certainly possible in here. If we were to get back down into this area, I would be a lot more confident of more upside move. But we'll have to watch this closely. Just that we're a little bit extended here in the market. No major concern here, though. Let's take a look at the economic calendar today. Now, the economic calendar really doesn't have anything that's going to move the market around today. As you can see, we have mortgage applications, we have Redbook, FHFA, housing price index, and Richmond Fed. None of those are key reports that move the market around. So kind of a light day today, and that means everything is going to be focused on earnings. We have about 90 companies, just over 90 companies reporting earnings today, and some big players. Now, last night, IBM actually reported a good set of earnings, gapping up this morning, breaking through this price resistance. So if you're looking for some charts, there may be some charts starting to show up in some of these stocks like that report well. Now, I wouldn't suggest ever chasing a stock that gaps up like that. Wait for the next entry into the trade. Wait for that trend to develop here, and there may be an opportunity in a stock like IBM. I did see Procter & Gamble reported positively this morning, and they're gapping up already. So looking pretty good in some areas here. So as long as those reports continue to come out strong, we could be in pretty good shape. Now, so for some stocks to take a look at, several really good patterns showing up in the market, even though there was a pullback yesterday. EA is a really great looking roundabout and breakout pattern. If we take a look here, this is those moving averages all coming up to provide some support right here in this area. Really nice looking pattern to watch, and good potential, I think, in this chart. You might want to keep an eye on EA as a potential position. Also seeing some really good signs, in stocks like Roku breaking its downtrend, holding a level of support. No buy signal in here yet, but something to be keeping an eye on and watching out for. So we're seeing a lot of those kind of patterns really develop. Take a look at Nike. Nike moved up nice and strongly here, holding up well yesterday, really ignoring the sell-off. Any rest, any consolidation, pull back in here to move back over toward its trend, I would be keeping an eye on Nike. You can see my original alert here on Nike was right off of the downtrend. this is a pattern I trade a lot. Right off of this downtrend, pop through, pull back. I wait for buyers to show up, and right here would have been the entry into that trade. That's working out really, really well, and Nike holding up nicely yesterday, so it might be one to pay attention to and put on your list. Another chart I really like is Home Depot. Home Depot breaking its downtrend, showing a nice inverted head and shoulders type pattern showing up here on the chart. We just need a little bit more push. We just, you know, I thought we had it on Friday. To yesterday's pullback broke that back down, but we need just a little bit more push to maybe fire this up and pop this out, and then we have some upside potential in here. So keep an eye on Home Depot. So with that, everyone, hey, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. I want to wish you great profits. And if this is the first time you've seen these videos, please do me a favor. Click that subscribe button on YouTube, follow me button on Facebook, click those thumbs up buttons and leave a comment. Thank you very much for all of you who do that. I truly appreciate it. You guys are helping to support this channel and make it grow. You know, I don't intend to make any money with this channel. The whole point of this is just simply to provide good quality information to everyone. By the way, later on today, I have to get the video put together. Last night I did a public class for everyone on an indicator that I think could be really, really handy to a lot of folks. I'll turn it on here real quick so you can get a look at it if you've never seen it. I do a full class on this. It's a trend following indicator, just works really, really well. So that will be uploaded to the YouTube channel later today if you want to take a peek at that later on. So I thought I would pass that along. So thank you, everyone, for your support of the channel. Thank you for leaving comments and clicking those thumbs up buttons. It means a ton to me. So with that, everyone, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. Everyone, trade wisely, be safe, remember, never give up on yourself, and we'll talk to you all bright and early Thursday morning. Have a great one.